item from each table, so I am looking for someone to volunteer. Ms. Simpson's table.
Okay. Well, we have so many cookies, so we can only get one good one or all.
Yes, ma'am. You can kind of kind of.
Okay. What we really liked is the fact that there was passion for the profession and was real, not fake. And what was established by the head was trickled down to the children. So they knew that they could not make excuses. They knew that their background couldn't define them. So the expectations were so high that the kids just recognized it was a no-nonsense atmosphere. And this is what we have to do to achieve, and we will achieve by all means necessary.
Jumping back to Lorraine. Thank you, ma'am.
All right. Our group talked a lot about the idea that they are responsible for their own education and that they might not be responsible about for their home life, which I think was a good relief. But also that structure, respect, and discipline are important, but she said they're not the most important thing. The most important thing is rigor, and that bringing that into your classroom, you can have really good discipline but not have a rigorous classroom, which means people won't learn as much. Or you can be a really rigorous teacher but not have any discipline, and then they won't learn anything. So you have to have both of those, with rigor being the more important of the two, which I think was really important. And then we also talked about how everybody has to be involved, including the principal, the staff, and all the teachers, and that together, that's how that works, and that everybody respects the students, but also one another.
Very good, very good. Okay, I'm transferring right on the Turner's table.
Okay, we had several of the same things, but we said we cannot teach in chaos, to accept no excuses, and that it was 14 to 16 hours a day was the workload to be effective as a teacher. And we also love that she said that teachers have to work like maniacs.
Are yours on post-its?
Yes.
Or okay, I guess fine. Okay. I'll collect that. Ms. Boyd's group.
Okay, we kind of derailed from the same idea. We basically said what stood out. One was that though the principal and the educators, they were sold out to the children being winners. I mean, they were, before they saw that they were winners, they were already sold out to them being winners. They set boundaries with rules, respect, and even love. They focused on school and not on the home life, which allowed every child to be established on the same blanket. Home life is different, but the school life was, everyone was on the same playing field to be expected to study, to be educated, to do the rigorous work.
Love it. So you guys have one poster?
Big ticket item is not to use disability background or home life as an excuse not to push on forward.
Thank you. I have one group that needs to go.
The first thing that we said about it were, you know, how high the expectations were at the school, and that that were connected with me and us, is that she told the students that they couldn't control their home life, but they could control their school life, and how that really would release kind of a burden off of their shoulders and responsibility. I wrote down the difficult challenges were embraced. They talked about how learning the Japanese language was very hard, but they almost didn't even realize it because they were really enjoying that. And then Ashley wrote down, students won't learn when, you know, they don't respect the teacher. So that respect's gotta come first, and you know, you can't teach in chaos, and when students aren't, you know, respecting, it can lead to chaos.
I love it. You guys, we're gonna condense all of this and revisit again in our next staff meeting. Please know you guys are doing many of these things. These are things that we want to incorporate into our schoolhouse. It's always already a place of great expectations, but there are things we want to really hone in on. She talked about the staff being just maniacs, but we gotta push that. Ms. McDowell, we will have to continue to make sure the climate is conducive. She talked about the teachers not being able to teach if the classroom isn't managed and structured, and they can own that piece, but environment and culture-wise, we have to own making sure that you guys are able to be good teachers and supported and respected and respecting the kids. So that's something that we'll have to own, along with Mr. Williams. Yes, ma'am.
And something that wasn't said that I thought was very important too was exposure, making sure that the kids were exposed to things outside of the walls, because then when they do matriculate to the next level, they can express the exposures that have been a part of their lives. And they may not get that at home, so sometimes we do have to expose them to things that maybe their parents can't expose them to, you know, just besides, you know, teaching, or just give them different experiences, is all I'm saying.
Good point. Good point. I've been thinking a lot about that. That is a very good point. We haven't done a lot of field tripping because it goes too far in some schoolhouses. Some schoolhouses start having field trips month one of school, meaningless things. In all of my schools that do that, the scores are terrible. The kids do not grow academically. But then there's the other extreme, and I have to get us somewhere in the middle, because there are opportunities that our kids need to have and see to become more competitive. And so I have that. All right, you guys, switch gears. We're going to go and let Mrs. Childs spend some time. Or is the first, no, the first week is mine. First week. We're going to go quickly through our first week, and I have forms for the first week. But we really need to spend some time on it. We want to go quickly, but we need to visit it because there are a few changes, and I want to make sure that the new staff, thank you, really know what's going to happen that first week of school. So Dee's getting these out to everybody. Let me try to talk through some things without reading to you all. The first couple weeks leading up to September, I think, September 1st is a Friday. The 4th is an off day. Am I right?
It's September 4th.
September 4th is an off day, right?
Labor Day, yeah.
The 4th is an off day. The 1st is a Friday. So the 5th, we will begin to monitor your time. Up until then, I told my team leaders, I'm expecting you the first week just be on that playground at 7:40. Beyond that, you just need every day that week, 7:40. After that, the rest of the month of August, you just need to be here to pick up your kids. But you need to begin to transition yourself to your regular start time. If you're a para, just be here right at your duty. If you're a teacher, you're gonna be there to pick up your kids at 8, as long as you're here by 8 that first couple weeks. But I don't want any feedback or pushback or excuses come September 5th when you are expected to be here at your regular time. I can't change you. I cannot babysit you. I don't have the energy. Take this time to transition yourself from your summer sleep hours to your work hours. So if you need to get here, if you think on the first day of school, you can jump out of your vehicle at 7:39 and be on the playground and everything's ready to go, have at it. I'm all about that. September 5th, we're ready to play ball. Reports are coming up. Mrs. Dunn's office is gonna be sending you the email if you have not set to your normal start time. Paras, regular general ed paras, your start time is when this morning? Is it 7:20?
7:20.
7:20. Autism?
7:20.
7:20, so everybody's 7:20. So just begin to transition yourself there. We had an open house this Saturday. Try to come, opportunity to get in the building. We are not using you guys for the open house at all. So if you're in the building working, you're in the building working. We will tour the building, but we are not gonna say, okay, here's Ms. Johnson, you can meet with her. We're gonna let everybody know that you guys are going to be working. That is really mine and I, it's our opportunity to connect with the families. Yes, Ms.
I had a family asking just about how that worked, if they were gonna be in my room or not, so.
We're gonna have a central location. We have a flyer that we handed out to families. We'll hand it out for you guys just for the record. Why don't you give her Ms. Beckford's information and she'll be in contact. So we're gonna send the flyer out. I'll send it out to you guys. We're gonna open from about 10 to 1. 10 to 1. You can work in your room, you can do whatever. There will be a building tour. However, we are not stopping to hang out with any of you guys. Teachers, you start on the 14th, it's a paid day. Mrs. Childs is gonna talk about that in more detail during her time. My advice is don't come to Evanston. If I were you guys, I would just go wherever you're assigned to go. I wanna think that day is like 8:30 to 3:30, am I right?
Yes.
I wouldn't even come to school if I were you guys, but that's just me. August 15th, Paras report. If you are here and you're Ms. Williams, you're Ms. Price, you're Mr. Taylor, you're Mr. Browning, you guys are with your teachers, because you're here. But if you are not here, you will be in meeting a large part of the day. It stinks, but it is. So parents that are here, please make sure you work out something with your teacher in terms of when you guys are gonna get here, when you're gonna leave. Teachers and parents, Tuesday, the 15th, the day before school starts, you are required to work your 7 hours. We are not policing you. When you come, you come. When you leave, you leave. When you go to lunch, you go to lunch. Everybody's on their own schedule. We do that every year. Anybody have any questions about that? Please read through. Ask us questions while you have us here so we all are on the same accord. Newbies. Anybody that's new, please make sure you spend some time digesting all of this and meeting with your team leader or your partner. There's a power outage on September 7th. Remember, that's the day they turn off the power and you gotta leave early. You guys are all, I would recommend that you guys all get out of there about 3:30 because there will be no power at all. One thing we wanna go over is the new dismissal schedule. It is in a box at the very end of the paper. We're gonna do things a little different because dismissal has been choppy and I think we've been getting the kids out too early. Primary, Turner, your group back there, you guys are gonna begin dismissal at 2:07. 3:04, 2:09, 5:06, 2:11, and autism, you guys are gonna head out at 2:07. Bus riders, I thought that was printed somewhere. Bus riders should head, busers, daycare, you guys should all head to the lunchroom at 2:05. That's a change. Not 2 o'clock, 2:05. So